بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I want to welcome you all to our series on the wisdoms and benefits of trials and tribulations. And the last 2 days, alhamdulillah, we covered two of the wisdoms that Imam Izzuddin rahmatullahi alayhi mentions in his book. The first is that whenever we are faced with a trial or a tribulation, it allows us to recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It forces us to have a understanding of who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. We benefit from the ma'rifah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His power, His abilities, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's ultimate control. The second benefit that we spoke about yesterday, we mentioned that we also learn and we also have a ma'rifah of ourselves. So we have a ma'rifah, we learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we also then learn about who we are as a human being and our weaknesses and how we are not in control. There's a beautiful dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, "O Allah, do not leave us to our own doing even for a moment. La takilni ila nafsi tarfata'ain. O Allah, do not leave us to our own doing even for the duration of a blink of an eye." Because the reality is that if Allah left us in control, if we were given full control, even for a duration of a blink of an eye, the disaster we would create would be unimaginable. So when we are faced with a trial and tribulation, we tend to realize that we're not in control, and we are weak, and we're not able to, drive or be in that driver's seat in a proper way. Now, Imam Izzuddin rahmatullahi alayhi, he now talks about the third benefit that we achieve when we face trial and tribulation. And that is, we have a sense of sincerity and ikhlas with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we face this trial and tribulation. What does ikhlas mean? The word ikhlas means when you are sincere, but also when you do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when your priority is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the ultimate goal is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I am in need, I first turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I am sick, I first turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I am sad, I first turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I am happy, I first turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the meaning of ikhlas. And some have discussed and explained ikhlas as one who does not appreciate praise, right? One who considers praise and criticism to be the same. So it doesn't necessarily bother him if he's criticized, but it also doesn't make him happy if he is praised. Now, being praised is not a bad thing. Being praised is not wrong, or does not mean that you're insincere in your actions. There was a Sahabi that came and, you know, asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a question about, "O Prophet of Allah, what if we do something and we're praised afterwards for doing what we did?" The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, That's a early glad tiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you truly did something for the sake of Allah, for the sake of God, and someone then praises you for that deed or for that action, that is an early glad tiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we are faced with trial and tribulation, it gives us the ability to understand and to also actualize sincerity within our lives. And so Imam Izzuddin Abdus Salam rahmatullahi alayh, in discussing this, he brings an ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala touches you with harm, or if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes for you harm, or harm afflicts us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ, that none can remove that harm except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we start to realize and become sincere in our call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that there is nobody that can remove that illness from us except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a very important concept. An important concept that we have to teach ourselves, and an important concept that we have to teach our children. When our children are sick, and we are giving them medicine, what are we teaching our kids about that medication? oh my child, I am giving you this medication, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shafi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that gives shifa. So we're taking this medication as a means because we are taught to take asbab and means in our life. We're taught to use the means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has afforded us, but never allow the means to take precedence over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we're taking that medication, we're reminding ourselves that I'm taking this medication as a means, but the ultimate cure comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can take on protection from means, but ultimate protection comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the sense of security that we have, or the sense of sincerity that we learn when we are faced with trials and tribulations. But then he brings another ayah, which is actually the ayah that he really wants us to focus on and addresses this concept of ikhlas. He says, فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. That when any of you, or when you, or when they embark upon a ship, when they get on a ship and they start sailing, what happens? They turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they turn to Allah with sincerity within religion. And then Allah afterwards says that when they get off that ship, it's as if nothing happened. So in Surah Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the condition of the human being, where when we are, رَبُّكُمُ الَّذِي يُجْجِي لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ فِي الْبَحْرِ وَالْبَحْرِ. Right, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that allows the ships to sail on in the sea. And whenever insan, whenever the human being is faced with a trial while he is on that ship, وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَن تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّا. Right, so when they're faced with a trial and tribulation, when they're on that boat, when they're in that ship, when we're on that flight and we start to experience that turbulence, how many of you have been on a flight where you started reading your du'as? I have been on many flights where the turbulence was so bad that I started reading my du'as. I started reading my kalima. That if I have to leave, I have to leave with iman, I have to leave with the kalima. So many times, we're faced with this difficulty that in that moment of trial, we turn to the highest level of sincerity and connecting to Allah. Even a person who doesn't believe will start calling out to God in that moment. And this is what Imam Izzuddin rahmatullahi alayh is informing us. That as human beings, we have these moments that within that moment of trial and tribulation, you tend to reach the peak of your sincerity. Because you realize that you're not in control. But the highest level of sincerity is when we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before anybody else. Now when you're in a ship and that ship starts to rock and those waves are hitting, when you're on that flight and that turbulence is severe, right? Turbulence is you know, it's hitting that plane hard and the plane is, you know, you're in that moment, your heart is sinking, your stomach feels a certain way. In that moment, before you turn to any means, you actually turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to learn from trials and tribulations. Is that as soon as you're hit with that difficulty, the first response that any human being should have is, oh Allah. The first being that we turn to is Allah. Not my bank account, not my spouse, not my parents, not my doctor, not medication. The first being that we turn to in any situation that we are in is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so reflect and ask ourselves, when we go through happiness in our lives or challenges in our lives, do we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our first resort? Or is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our last resort? And then figure out, and then come to some conclusions that maybe I have my priorities upside down. Because it's this sincerity that we refer to that is going to save us in our grave, and this sincerity that's going to save us in the hereafter. When we are put into our graves, when that moment and time comes, and we're asked those questions by the angels in the grave about who is your Lord and who is your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what was the religion that you followed, at that moment, at that point, your tongue is not going to speak what it was used to saying. Rather, your heart will speak what it was used to believing. If the heart believes that medication is what gives me a cure, if the heart believes is that my wealth that gives me happiness, if the heart believes that it's the vacations and the travels that we go on that brings about peace within our marriage, if we sort of think that the means is what's giving us happiness and is giving us contentment and is protecting us from harm, then that will be a very scary state to be in the hereafter. So trials and tribulations, in reality, is one of the greatest ni'mas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although we don't ask for it. Although we never ask for a trial, and the Prophet told us never to ask for a trial, we know that we are never challenged more than we can handle. لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah doesn't challenge us more than we can handle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, allows us to experience this because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to mold us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to purify us. We're all going through this purification process. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify us. But always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever you make dua, that, oh Allah, grant us afiyah. Oh Allah, grant us afiyah. Oh Allah, grant us afiyah. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah. This was a dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I can make this the dua that we should learn in today's session, is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for peace and protection and tranquility. Never ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a test. Even though there are so many benefits of these tests, it's never appropriate to ask Allah, oh Allah, bring it on. No, rather we ask Allah, just don't test us. Oh Allah, allow us to get through life as much as possible without being tested. But when that test comes, then we approach it with sincerity, we approach it with ikhlas, and that's one of the lessons that we learn by Imam Izzuddin Abdul Salam Rahmatullahi Alayhi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Imam for his great work in bringing these benefits and compiling these benefits and wisdoms so that you and I can benefit, inshallah, during these challenging times. As I wrap up, tomorrow's a day of Friday. And a lot of us are already worried about another Jum'ah coming without us having the opportunity to come to the masjid. Use this day and make this day as special as possible, even if we're not able to come to the masjid. Wake up. Make sure that you're showering, taking that sunnah bath on Friday. Make sure you're wearing the best of clothes. Make sure you're taking out time in the day to sit with your family and have the Jumu'ah prayer. Make sure we're taking out time for Suratul Kahf on this day of Friday. Do as many sunnahs as possible on this day. Don't limit yourself and your actions to just the Jumu'ah prayer on Friday. Even in these situations, especially in these situations, when we're pulled away, when we're not able to be in the masjid, then go above and beyond in all the other areas that we can. Whether it's Surah Kahf, whether it's sending salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in abundance, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Whether it's, waking up for the tahajjud prayer, qiyamul layl, the special hour before the fajr prayer where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts du'as. Whether it's, during the day, making sure that we're dressed the best and we smell the best, as a Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on Friday would dress the best and he would put on fragrance and he would do his miswak, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would come early, have a designated spot in your house that would be your musalla, and get there early, get there before time, sit down for a moment, for a while, and make some adhkar and make some dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make this day a day of value within our lives. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says the best day that the sun has ever risen on is a day of Friday. It's not only special because of Salatul Jum'ah. Salatul Jum'ah is definitely the pinnacle of the day of Friday, but there's so many other sunnahs and so many other things that we can also do to fulfill and to make this day of Friday amazing for us, inshallah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, to forgive us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq and the ability. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not test us more than we can handle. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to make this day of Friday the most amazing day of the week. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to do the best of deeds on this day and build a relationship with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on this special day of Friday. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.